address the needs of those with severe and profound hearing loss? It's a tricky question, but I am lucky and happy to have Bernadette Fulton as my Theory to Practice interview guest today. Hi, Bernadette.
Thanks for inviting me, Lisa.
Oh, nice to have you. So why is it worth us taking a closer look at those with severe and profound hearing loss?
Well, I think the thing about severe and profound hearing loss that it affects every aspect of your life. And audiologists often find that the practices that they have great success with people with mild to moderate hearing loss, they don't get the same benefits when they apply them to adults with severe to profound hearing loss. And the other thing is there are no guidelines out there to help audiologists improve their care of adults with severe to profound hearing loss.
That is concerning. So what have you and Phonak done to address these unmet needs?
Well, Phonak already offers a lot of very good resources for audiologists who are working with people with severe to profound hearing loss, but it's very hard to know what direction to go in to improve this. So we went to the experts. We gathered a group of experts, both in clinical practice of audiology, researchers, academics, and audiology teachers. And we asked them for guidance, for guidelines about how we could improve practices. Mm-hmm.
So let's get to the heart of the matter. Can you tell us what are the outcomes of you getting together with this group of experts?
Well, the outcome are some guidelines. It's a fantastic guideline and it has a number of very simple, straightforward recommendations and includes the evidence that support those recommendations. So it can be really simple things like you can get a better outcome if the client understands what you're counselling them or advising them to do. So you need to make sure that they are understanding, and that might require some text, it might require assigning interpreter and additional things. For this group, it may not be suitable to use an automated first fit. It's probably most important to verify that you are actually delivering the audibility that you believe that you're delivering. And another thing is that a remote microphone is not a luxury for this group. It's absolutely essential and should be prescribed for everyone.
Those are some excellent recommendations. So did you find any unexpected learnings during the process of making these guidelines?
I think all of us who worked on the guidelines were surprised at how poor the evidence was. There wasn't very much of it, and some of it was very old. And hearing aids and the technologies have improved so much in the last 10 or 15 years that some of it just wasn't relevant anymore.
And as audiology manager of Severe to Profound at Phonak, what was your most rewarding experience working with this fabulous group of experts from around the world?
Well, I think meeting them for the first time was a really wonderful professional experience. We met online. Many of the experts hadn't met one another before, and it just, the meeting just erupted. Everyone had so many questions. I felt like I was at a tennis match going from one to the other, and the questions really flew across the room, although in this case it was online, so they were really flying around the world. And another highlight was working with our editor, Laura Turton. Laura is developing a service for adults with severe to profound hearing loss. She works in a specialised service, and working with her was just inspirational.
Oh, that's wonderful to hear. Mm. I've personally read the guidelines, and I think they're comprehensive and just a really wonderful practical resource for hearing care professionals. So well done to you and the great group of experts that you convened. So well done. I'm just wondering if you could share with our viewers key takeaways that they can bring home with them today.
Well, there are so many in the guidelines, but I think one of the really key things is that the best technology can't do its job if it's not working properly or if it's not really well fitted. So really good practices in maintaining the equipment and in verification of the audibility is really important. A second thing is that the consequences of severe to profound hearing loss go way beyond what can be managed by hearing aids. And it's really important to recognise some of the psychosocial and the real communication challenges that these people are working with. And if it's not within the capacity of the audiology service to meet these needs, that they can refer on so that they can be managed by other professionals. And perhaps another little tip is that sometimes the old ways are the good ways, and I had completely forgotten about how fantastic hearing dogs can be.
Those are excellent takeaways. Thank you very much, Bernadette. We really appreciate you sharing your expertise and your time with us today.
If you would like to learn more about the management of severe to profound hearing loss, or if you want to download the guidelines, it is published in Seminars on Hearing. Thanks to Phonak, it is open access and available to everyone on phonakpro.com. Thank you for watching.